Hey, I'm Michael Hoff with Digital Theologian. Welcome to day six of 40 Days with Jesus as we dive into the second half of chapter three, looking at John the Baptist and his testimony about Jesus. In John 3:22, we see Jesus and his disciples going out into the Judean countryside and beginning to baptize. And so as Jesus is starting to have this ministry of baptism, it looks very similar to the ministry of John the Baptist. And so all of a sudden, John is back on the scene and we have some interaction between the disciples of John the Baptist and a Jew who's come from Jerusalem, most likely, out into the countryside. There's a conversation, we're told, surrounding purification. It shouldn't be any surprise that the theme of purification comes up here at the end of chapter 3. It was in chapter 2 with the wedding of Cana and those vessels that Jesus filled with wine that were originally used for ritual purification. And then we see Jesus cleansing the temple in John 2, and that is all about restoring pure worship, where commerce had taken over, where abuse of the poor had taken over, where the Gentiles had been pushed out of their place of worship. That was all restored. It was about purity of worship, purity in their relationship with God. And so we've seen purification coming up, cleansing, baptism, right? These themes keep coming up. And now here we have John's disciples interacting with some of the Jewish leadership surrounding this issue of purification. Man, the disciples of John the Baptist come to him and they're like, look, Jesus, the one that you testified about, he's out here in the countryside now and he's baptizing more people. Everybody is going to him to get baptized. He's the latest and greatest. Jesus is the new guy on the scene, and John's disciples are concerned that somebody is going to overtake his ministry. John has such a great response. He points out the fact that everything that we've received comes from God. And beyond that, John said, hey, look, I testified from the beginning that I am not the Messiah and that there is one coming after me. Look, I am not the bride. I am not the groom in this situation. I'm the best friend. I am the groom's best friend. And when I hear his voice, I am happy. I am excited. I love being at the wedding and being able to celebrate with the groom and with the bride. It is not about me. John the Baptist is acknowledging that he must increase, I must decrease, that the ministry of Jesus is going to be the ministry that matters moving forward. And so as we come to the final paragraph of John chapter 3, we have this acknowledgement that, and there's a message that's coming from above, just like we need to be born from above, that there's one who gives the Spirit without measure, that same Spirit that we see in John chapter 3 in the conversation with Nicodemus, the Spirit that nobody knows where it comes from, nobody knows where it's going, that Spirit is given without measure through Jesus. And that as Jesus is pouring out His Spirit, and there is an opportunity for us to come and to believe and to acknowledge and to accept what Jesus is doing, to accept his message, to live our lives in accordance to that. In the temple, Jesus is making a statement that God is his Father. And here now, as we're coming to the very end of chapter 3, we have again that familial connection between the Father and the Son. This is a further affirmation of the message of Jesus, the ministry of Jesus, and what Jesus has done so far in relation to purification, in relation to baptism, and to his ministry as a whole. In verses 35 and 36, we're told that the Father loves the Son and has placed all things into his hands. And then the next verse says something that is a little bit uncomfortable for a lot of us. We love the first part of verse 36 because it says, whoever believes in the Son has eternal life. But what we don't like is that it also says later in the verse that whoever disobeys the Son won't experience that same life. Our actions have consequences. There are ways that lead to life. There are actions that lead to disobedience and ultimately to death. And so my appeal is that we do what Jesus has encouraged, what the Gospel of John has encouraged so far, and that is to bring those things to the light. and let them, like the waters of baptism, wash over us and be cleansed. Let that be washed away and for us to experience the purification that comes through Jesus. He's offering in the Spirit purification, washing, cleansing that leads to new life, to eternal life, life from above that transforms who we are and where we're at. And so I want to encourage you today, choose that life. Choose the life that brings joy to the Father, that delights Jesus, and let's see what your life might look like as you move forward. Hey, thank you so much for watching these videos. If you're enjoying them, please go ahead, click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and if you're in love with it, go ahead and click that little bell so you get notifications every time I upload a new video. It's my hope that these videos continue to be a blessing to you. Thank you so much for tuning in, and have a wonderful day.